And as you struggle to do your taxes and look for every deduction you can find, you'll probably end up paying a lot more in taxes than you really want to. But did you know some of the biggest, most profitable companies that do business in this country, indeed in this state, paid no taxes at all, and in some cases paid less than nothing? I did some investigating, and the bad news is the experts tell me with today's political climate, there's virtually no chance to change it. How much you paid?
$3,085.
Would it surprise you to know that Duke Power, which made $1 billion last year, paid this much less than you did?
That's not fair.
And Duke Energy and GE aren't the only ones who don't pay the 35% corporate tax rate. A study by the Citizens for Tax Justice says the majority of Fortune 500 companies don't either.
These companies are paying 18% of their profits in tax, about half the legal rate.
In fact, Matthew Gardner says 30 companies that made billions in profits paid less than nothing in taxes over the last 3 years. And among them, Duke Energy, DuPont, Verizon, General Electric, and Wells Fargo, who all operate in our state.
Tax avoidance is a right.
That's what Professor Joseph Hagan tells his graduate students at ECU.
By taking these things and hiding them in the tax law, politicians can say, I cut your taxes.
So if loopholes are not illegal, why should we care?
They're shifting the cost of funding public investments from these companies to small businesses, to working families, to everyone else. And that's a bad thing when we're in an economic downturn.
I teach my students a good tax system is efficient, sufficient, convenient, and fair. Our tax system is not sufficient. It does not raise enough money. It is not convenient because it is so complex. It's hard both for the government to administer and for us to comply with it. It's not efficient because it's affecting different industries in different ways. It's affecting different companies. And fair?
I called Tom Williams with Duke Energy, and he pointed out Duke is just aggressively using the same deductions open to any business. A big one was the Bonus Depreciation Act, passed in 2008 by the Bush administration as an incentive, and until this year it was in effect. It allowed companies to take a windfall of full depreciation on equipment now instead of over time.
I think that makes sense because we're a very capital-intensive industry, and we build big stuff that lasts a long time.
But did Duke avoid paying taxes?
All the taxes are paid ultimately, but you're just able not to pay them immediately.
But what we see year in and year out with companies like Duke Energy and a lot of these energy companies is that they do keep finding a ways to postpone these taxes indefinitely. Their taxes don't seem to be going back up ever.
And while Duke Energy made $5 billion and paid no federal taxes, Williams points out Duke customers benefited. They pay 10 to 30% less for power than the rest of the country. That sounds good, but
any dollar of tax revenue that these big multinational corporations aren't paying is a dollar that you and I have to pay. It's a dollar that small businesses have to pay.
Who writes tax law?
Okay. The person who doesn't write tax law is your congressman and senator.
In fact, often industry lobbyists will hand a lawmaker's staff a pre-written law. The staff adds something, the lawmaker adds something, and before you know it,
it's so complex. The waters are muddy. You can't see the bottom. You don't really know what's going on in the water.
But again, lobbying Congress is legal. And over 3 years, electric utilities spent $1.5 billion to lobby for their interests. The pharmaceutical and insurance industries are the only two that paid more.
In many cases, it's because Congress has enacted not just industry-specific, but company-specific tax breaks. It's pitting some companies against their competitors. And the high tax companies have every right to be angry about that.
We've got a wonderful tax system in that we ask the people to tell us what they owe, and we generally take their word for it. But if they don't think they're being treated fairly, they're not going to comply.
And we Americans, above all else, like to be treated fairly. But you don't have a lobbyist or a bank of accountants to cut your taxes. You also do not have inverted incentives or people to push lawmakers for a tax amnesty on the billions of dollars in offshore profits you would like to bring back to the U.S. without paying any taxes on. And if the playing field needs to be level, as CTJ says, then why don't the majority of companies that do end up paying some taxes go after Congress to change things? Well, in 1986, things did change. It didn't last. At 11, more on that and the corporate argument that tax incentives create jobs.